saw.
This is another episode of Boys Casa on content, people, and places. My name is Jeff Abuaje, and I have with me here my two gentlemen who are going to help us in today's discussion. I have Nana Danso and Mauli. Welcome, guys.
Thank you, bro.
How has the week been?
Stressful, but Sally, we move.
How stressful?
Sally, you know, work stuff and all those things, Sally. And I was down with malaria this weekend, so it wasn't easy at all.
No, okay, Nana Danso.
Charlie, everything is fine. We have been managing. I mean, this Ghana Today beer, yeah. Only management. Without management, you can't survive.
Are we living by magic?
Oh, not really, but Charlie, management and co.
All right, so lovely viewers, today we have an interesting topic to discuss with you, as usual. And my guests are ready for this discussion, and I hope that you are also ready. And so, yes, today what we are going to talk about is, what are the advantages and disadvantages of big nyash in a relationship? So we just want to look at the physical attributes of the lady when it comes to relationship, and what are the advantages when it comes to the ass, that is the buttocks. And so, yes, Nana Danso, first of all, I want to know, what do you look out for when it comes to relationship? Like, what do you look in a lady before you decide to even approach her?
I think this one is a tough one, but I mean, once a topic, you need to discuss it.
Okay.
First of all, the looks is something that, because when you see every person, what you see is what will attract you.
Okay.
So the looks is very, very important whenever you see any beautiful lady. Because me, when I see a lady, I started from her leg before I got to her face.
Okay.
Yeah, so from her leg, I've been watching gradually.
What do you look at when it comes to the leg? What do you consider?
I mean, how the legs, the looks of the legs, then gradually I graduate to the middle. So you see that at that point you have to check how the booms is before you graduate to the top to see the face. I mean, face, yeah, not always look at faces, because Charlie, sometimes faces attract you, the other side too have to be more attractive.
So does it mean that if the lady is lacking in one of these things that you just mentioned, you're not going to approach her?
Oh, that's what I'm saying. I start from down.
Mm-hmm.
So if from there everything is perfect, well, the one side, I can cut it
off. But no one is perfect. So if you talk about perfect, what are you talking about?
No, I'm not saying perfect.
Mm-hmm.
But I mean perfection, yeah. But when I start looking from the top, from the down coming,
mm-hmm.
I mean, the booms can cry. I mean, those are the things that will appeal your eye.
So that's what I'm asking. If she's lacking in one aspect, let's say she has the boobs, but then she's not having the nice leg like you just mentioned, are you still going to approach her?
Oh, yeah, I'll overlook.
Okay.
Overlook. Because when the medal is appealing, oh Charlie, I overlook at it then. Because, man, yeah, when we see things, Charlie, we want to grab.
Okay. Mm. So, Mauli, what do you also look out for in a lady before you even decide to approach her?
Well, your question is quite broad, but physical appearance matters a lot.
Okay.
So
my brother, the moment you love
no, relax for me. When we were talking, I kept quiet. I was just looking at you.
I know what you like. So, no, that's why.
But you will get there. But you will get there. But
the general, yes, yes,
you will get there. Right. Okay. So the physical appearance, just like I was saying, it matters.
Okay.
So the moment you see the person, first of all, I mean, the facial. I mean.
Okay, so that's the first. Nana Danso starts from the leg, but you start from the face.
I'll go with the top bottom approach. Went to the right.
Okay.
Yes. So you see, so that, I mean, you can't tell me. I mean, if you like, I mean, facial expression or the facial matters a lot. You understand?
Okay.
So that, I mean,
it matters, but because the natural people that have the booms sometimes like the facial.
You get there. I know you also like it. You get there. The way I'm talking about the facial thing, you are going straight to the
Okay,
the face. the face. That's the first thing that will attract you to the person.
What else?
Because I'm sure if the face, excuse my language, it's not all that. I mean, you will not even approach the person in the first place. So the face. Then after the face, that is where you go to look for the other features.
Mm-hmm. Like?
Which you'll be getting to. Like, mm-hmm. you know, the boobs and then the ass and those things, you know. And then the legs, I mean, with nice legs with some meat on, you know, calves, good calves.
Okay.
That's the legs we are talking about. Right.
So just like I asked Dana Danso, if the lady is lacking in any of these qualities you just mentioned, are you still going to approach her?
Well, I wouldn't, because I'm not sure that relationship or that thing you are going for would end well or will last.
Okay. So right. It means you are looking for a perfect person.
Not perfect as in, I mean, well,
in
perfect
your, in for your me. World, yeah. Like in your world of looking at the attribute of the person.
Yeah, it should be,
perfect.
Yeah, attribute. It should be some, we will call it specs. It should be, you should have those specs that I'm looking out for.
But you can't get all those things from a woman.
Well, all those things, you know, the good looking, the face,
one
I could get it. The ass, the boot, oh no.
So if
I mean, they're all around.
Okay, so if the lady is having the ass, but then the face is not that good, will it still go?
I said I'll look the face first. That's what I said. The face first.
Okay.
Face first. Then before I'll look out for the other features. Mm-hmm. If she has the ass, it's a plus.
Alright.
Are you okay? It's a plus. Uh-huh.
Okay. So
but
now
face first.
So now let's look at. Let's look at. Okay.
I think Maulidia, he likes makeup, so they will just.
Baba, it's like you are trying. No, you are trying to talk for him instead of talking for yourself.
You see,
now
the way he's talking about facial things.
Uh huh.
I mean, majority of our ladies today,
mm-hmm.
Charlie, they push something on something.
Explain.
Oh. I mean, makeups.
Mm-hmm.
So but you apply the makeup, definitely. So, you wash your face. Wouldn't you wash your face?
When you visit them in their house, one of my pastor told me that if you want to see a rare face of a lady,
visit her
early morning.
Mm-hmm.
When she's there, you knock her door. When she opens it, she say, Charlie.
You see that's the real face you'll be
seeing. You that I met you yesterday.
Then you see
that's the real face you'll be seeing.
Alright, so okay, let's look at the role that these facial or the physical attributes we are just discussing play when it comes to relationship. What role does it play, Maoli?
Well, I think we should be direct.
Mm-hmm.
Physical, as in, are we talking about the as yet? I believe that's the topic
you mentioned.
No,
I'm just asking general question about
this. This is a general question.
The physical attributes of a lady. You just mentioned the face, the ass, the boobs, the legs, and all that. So I'm just asking, what role does this physical attribute of a lady play when it comes to relationship?
Well,
in general,
I mean, even with you yourself, the man,
mm-hmm.
you feel good in a way. I mean, you feel motivated. Gosh. If you have, a woman who, have those features you are looking out for.
Okay.
I mean, you are proud of yourself even if you are going out with her. I mean, the all right alone, that I mean, you know, so I mean basically that's what
my brother
basically that's what I mean. But aside that, the other ones I believe will get there. Those are bedroom matters, you'll get there, right?
Definitely.
But yeah,
it's like
those
you
are bedroom matters
today.
But but as for the outward listing or the general one, just like you put it, I mean when you are out with her,
mm-hmm.
I mean, yeah, you feel proud of yourself as a man, you know. Yeah,
so it means that you are considering all these physical attributes just to please people out there.
Not people, but yourself. Yeah, that's why I said you feel proud yourself as a man.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, you are motivated. I mean, that's actually me so many of baby now, so not just saying.
So do you agree?
Any
oh yeah, 100%. I mean, from what my brother is saying, sometimes man, if you are there, these are the things that will make people feel challenged. Acquires our guy.
Okay.
Because the lady at your back could determines how the level that you are, because guys of today we like a lot of outing.
Okay.
And I mean, we are doing some house party, we are doing something, Charlie, everybody is bringing his fiance, Charlie, you because yours is not good. It's not looking good. You can't present yours.
Okay.
So I mean, every gentleman or for our generation, that's how come the ladies are doing a lot of things to appear beautiful in the sight of their men, because every man wants to present. So one of the things that men of today look like, we look at is the I mean, the appearance of the woman, because the woman has to appear very,
presentable.
But I believe you guys will agree with me that it is not every lady that has all these attributes that you are just mentioning. So does it mean that they don't deserve love?
No, don't get us wrong. You are getting us wrong, or probably you are getting me wrong.
Okay.
It's about choices, right? You might like that one. I might not like it. So I mean,
but right now, my brother, right now, in fact, about 90% of women today are looking presentable, because Charlie, the way they would dress, the way they put things on things, Charlie.
All right, so straightforward to the question, boobs and ass, which one do you like, Mowgli?
Wow, boobs and ass. How about I like both? Like they go hand in hand, you know.
So that one, you call it boobs and
ass. Okay, so I'm just giving you, just choose one. Okay, so he just mentioned in the introduction that okay, if the lady's having one aspect of the physical attributes and then it's lacking in others, he will still not go for the lady. So in that case, if the lady's having the boobs and it's not having the ass or the ass, will you still go?
Well, I will.
Then it means you are contradicting yourself here.
I'm not contradicting, but you see, I said I like both, you know. I like both, but if you should give me a choice, strictly to choose, I mean, between the two, one, right? I think I'll go for the ass though, but Charlie, it is what it is, you know.
Let's even use this opportunity to also advise our ladies out there. This month is Breast Cancer Awareness Month. And so our ladies out there, if you are watching us, please take care of your boobs for us, because it's very, very important.
And you know, on the 13th, some this thing was going viral that, I mean, they needed to do a video call for their men to watch things, but they refused.
They're no bragging.
So next year, you're not going to allow that.
No, they should do a call for who? For their men, if you are with your man, why do you have to do a video call?
No, this one, I want to do it via internet. So we put it on the thing, and your gentleman have to watch things.
And I'm saying that you are with your man, so why go on, I mean, social media to showcase
your boobs? Not all of them are good, but they are men. That's
so if you come home, then you come and watch the boobs. Okay, so you two, I mean, the boobs and the ass, which one do you like?
Both of them complement each other. The other one, the ass, normally, I mean, for outside view, for people to see, and I mean, but for the booms, Charlie, can suck to your satisfaction. You know, as they say, men
suck to your satisfaction.
Every man is always a baby. Like,
okay.
Because this is what keep us. It keep us, I mean, because when you suck a lot of breath, I believe you'll be more active.
Okay.
And that's why you have breast milk. that's why when you give birth, you see, you have to give your child the breast milk after 6 months before you give the child the food, because when you give the child the breast milk, it will keep the child very healthy.
Okay.
So I believe when you grow up too, then you still suck
breast milk.
You still suck. I mean,
the milk.
Breast milk.
Okay,
Charlie, you live strong.
Okay, so now
mentally and everything.
Now that we know that you are interested in both the boobs and the ass, you go for a short breather.
I will title it boobs ass.
Yes, we will go for a short breather, and when we return, we are going to look at the advantages and disadvantages of the ass. Don't go anywhere. Welcome back from that breather. We are still looking at the advantages and disadvantages of boobs in relationship. We are being sponsored by TJ Studios, Rosabelle Hotel, Sankey's Restaurant. So please do get in contact with them as their details show on the screen for more details. Guys, welcome back.
Thank you, my brother.
What is the advantage of boobs?
Or advantage? Us,
yes. In a relationship.
I mean, the advantage of boobs, if I may say, it keeps the man, I mean, very active.
Mm-hmm.
In terms of the bedroom stuff.
Okay.
Yeah, because it's saying that it is like when you are having intercourse and I mean you are playing romantics and other things. I mean the bust plays a lot of role because we have some ladies that have their feelings in their nipples and other things. So Charlie, if the thing is there, especially those that have a big bust.
Mm-hmm.
Majority of them have their feelings.
Odi, Shanko.
Yeah, their feelings in their nipples. So Charlie, what during the act, when you are playing with it, I mean they feel that, and you as a man to us earlier commented that men, you cannot do away with the sucking of breast. So those things too, it keeps us, I mean, healthy in a lot of the mentally, because during the breast cancer, they are saying men to suck a lot of, I mean, breast and other things.
Okay. A certain doctor also came to dispute that, to say, when you're no clue, even well, if you sacra, if you get breast cancer, you still get it.
That doctor, he want to train. So forget about that doctor. Well, I mean, that's what we've been told since ages now. So
okay, so according to you, the advantage of the boobs is for sexual pleasure.
Oh yeah.
What of the ass?
The ass, as I earlier stated, I mean, both sexual pleasure and I mean outside too, because a lot of people, when me for instance, if my lady have a big boobs, when I'm working actually, I can just delay small, then be watching how actually the thing is shaking in the attack. The same thing that people to outside actually, when they see Charlie, this girl here, she's heavy. Look at what I mean, she's carrying. So it looks more appealing to.
I'm sure Nana Mauli is going to agree with Nana Danso on the sexual pleasure of the boobs and the ass. So I want to know from you, is it that because the young generation are focusing on these things that is causing divorce in marriages?
Well, I don't know how that is causing divorce unless you explain further, but
because at the end of the day, you don't look at other qualities of the lady. If the lady is having the boobs and the ass, you focus on that and then you go into relationship with the person and marry the person. And then you enter into the marriage and realize that, okay, apart from the sexual pleasure, there's more to marriage. And so you are not able to be compatible with that person. Don't you think?
Okay, that I agree with you to some extent, yes. So people mostly focus on those physical, I mean, attributes or aspects. And then they neglect the other aspect, the moral aspect of it, right? Or the aspect. So that I agree, right? It is causing a lot of divorce cases. But it should be a balance something,
okay,
right? So as much as you look out for the physical appearance, you should also look at the character as well. Mm-hmm. I mean, it is equally important, mm-hmm, if not even more important than those physical attributes, right? Yes, so that I agree with you.
I mean, both things work hand in hand because before you get married to somebody, at least you have to know the person for some time.
Okay.
So you have to study the character, because when one thing hard believe is that if you want to marry somebody, you first of all have to become, you guys have to be friends before.
Okay, so the physical attributes and the inward attribute, that is the character of the person, the attitude of the person, which one will you go for? Which one will you prefer?
Me, I want both. Because it complements each other. Because if you have the physical attributes,
mm-hmm,
and don't have the inner one, definitely when you settle, the inner one will override the physical one, because after we had been staffs, you're going to live on reality grounds.
Okay.
So the reality grounds will come from, it's like, yeah, say, so if whatever thing that you've hiding, you definitely will come out. And we are going to settle for forever. So both things complement each other. So if you are a young man and you're only looking for one aspect, it will go around to come and affect your relationship or your marriage, because if you don't look at the other side too will come and hit you.
Okay.
And at the end of the day, you got married, you don't have peace in the marriage, because what the physical things that you are looking, a lot of married people can find those things outside their marriage.
Okay, so Mauli, would you agree with me that because of some of these physical attributes that we just mentioned, the boobs and the ass, we are actually forcing our ladies to do some kind of surgeries to their bodies that they are not supposed to, and it's affecting them?
Are we the ones forcing them?
Yes, because every guy was a big ass.
Well, not all guys, but I think within themselves, they have come to appreciate the fact that even when they have those features on themselves, it makes them look, I mean, good or presentable, right?
Okay.
And that is why I believe they are going for it. Yes, that aspect of the guys, the craze for, I mean, those features, I mean, with the guys, is also could be a factor, right?
Okay.
But I'm sure they themselves have also come to the realization that those features, I mean, when they have it on them, it makes them presentable. So guys could be partly blamed for that, right?
Yeah, but why is that when we are doing this beauty pageant, we don't look out for big ass and big boobs?
So every stage, I mean, the beauty pageant, they look at people who are eloquent, people who are smart, I mean, people who are presentable in terms of working. So I was even going to add up to what my brother just said. I mean, not everybody looking for the physical thing, but right now, even the ladies that don't have the small booms and other things, Charlie, the way they have tuned their mind, the way they work, Charlie, you are there. The thing is not that big, but it will look appealing to your eye.
Okay.
So right now, I mean, the ladies. That's why I earlier stated that about 90% of the ladies right now know how to keep themselves, know how to put their things in order. So right now, the competition is not all around the big things. But right now, those people who are skinny, who are cute and other things too, Charlie, I also know they are swag to the top.
Okay, so now let's look at some disadvantages. Now, if you look at it being for sexual pleasure and all that, and also you being having that confidence when you are out there with your friends, so what are some of the disadvantages when it comes to big boobs and ass?
Well, from what I have learned or heard, right, if you have a big ass, right, the disadvantage or one of the disadvantages is that when you, when you get older,
okay,
right, yes, in your old age, you tend to experience some waist and joint pains and all those things.
Mm-hmm.
So last time I heard this Kuma old actress, Christiane Awuni, right?
Yeah,
she was being interviewed, right?
I mean, she has it.
Yes, she has it. She was being interviewed and then she was, I mean, narrating her what she has been going through, right?
Okay.
Yes, in terms of the disadvantages, right? So she keeps, I mean, experiencing persistent waist pains, right? And I believe that is one of the disadvantages, right? Aside those, I mean, weaknesses, I don't see any major disadvantage, especially if yours is natural.
Okay.
Yeah, if it is natural, unless you've gone to do some surgery, that is where other complications set in. But other than that, if it is natural, aside those waist and those pains, I don't see any major effect on it again.
And that's what we want to add up to the
disadvantages. Yeah. I mean, what my brother is saying is very loud. I mean, the big ones, it's for the young boys. But when you grow up, I mean, the thing is not even looking appealing again.
Okay.
Because the bones, everything, Charlie, flat.
But you're going to stay with the person?
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. I mean, for the early ages, I mean, it looks attractive. But when the thing is growing, everything, and the person too will go through a lot of, I mean, let's say what my brother just said. I mean, when you are aging, the body is becoming more weaker. I mean, you feel more lazy to walk. All these things are attributed to the big. And another one that I wanted to add to is, even at your primary age, at the primary stages of the big nyas and the big bones, I mean, most of the ladies don't feel comfortable.
Okay.
Because when they are walking, people be talking about them, teasing them. Hey, Charlie, they don't feel comfortable. So I know a lot of ladies that have those features that they don't want to go to places that, I mean, a lot of people have gathered. Okay. Always they want to feel isolating themselves from the people.
Those with big
ass, yeah,
they don't want to go to places.
Yeah, because those people that have
way back, not
those
now.
People that have extremely big.
Yeah.
When let's say
now they are the center of attraction.
Yeah, they are. But the way people talk about them, they to the fisher.
Are you sure?
Especially when they are walking alone on the streets, when men are sitting left, right, back center of the street, they say, hey, Charlie Otunye. I mean, they feel embarrassed.
As for this one, I beg to differ. The way they enjoy the attraction and everything.
They are enjoying. Especially when you walk to the street or maybe at doom and other places. The way the street boys bashes the people.
They bash them.
They feel a lot of embarrassment. They feel embarrassed.
Really? Yeah. Yeah, so we are wrapping up with our discussion on the advantages and disadvantages of the big ass and boobs in relationship. So I'll take my final words from my guest and then we'll sign out. Who wants to go first?
I'm gonna go first.
Okay, with all said and done, mm-hmm. right, it's all about preferences.
Okay.
Right? So if you do not have the big ass and boobs that we are talking about,
mm-hmm.
that's okay. You don't have to go have any surgery or whatever,
mm-hmm.
which will result in later complications, right? So, I mean, just stick to what God has given you. I mean, you are perfect in that way. God knows best, right?
Okay.
Yes. But aside that, it is about choice, right? So I might decide to go for what's the big ass and big boobs.
So you agree with Sarkodie, yeah? Choices,
you understand.
Yes. All right.
So I think that'll be my final submission.
No, that's so.
But before then, okay, maybe someone, I don't know, mm-hmm. someone was, I mean, I was discussing something with a friend some time ago, and then we were arguing the African countries, which of the ladies in the these various African countries has the big, I mean, or has big boobs and mm-hmm. ass. And then I don't know if you would want to.
The
comparison was basically between Nigeria and then.
Oh no, Nigeria, because they don't come inside.
They don't come inside.
Yeah, I mean, South African people too, they are there, but.
Yeah, they have the big
South things. South Africa, there. They are there. They have. I mean, South Africa, everything, they are big. I mean,
so Nigerians are out of the equation.
Oh, Nigerians, I don't see them much.
But, oh, I see. Mean, but oh, then. Nigeria brothers and sisters. Anyway, that's okay. So carry on.
Okay, I mean, yeah. For me, as my brother Riley said, it's good to have those features. I mean, naturally, but don't try to mutate, because I mean, God knows what He gave to you. So, I mean, no matter how you are, try to maintain yourself, keep yourself in a good shape. I mean, guys out there are interested in ladies that do not have those things, but they keep themselves very, very well.
Okay.
So as a lady, you need to look sharp and smart. Don't depend fully on solely on artificial stuff, but try to, be in your natural element.
Okay.
Because at the end of the day, it's going to affect you. So it's good to have the big thing, but if you don't force yourself.
It's good to have the big things, but if you don't have, don't force yourself. Thank you very much, our dear viewers. This is how we wrap up of today's show on the advantages and disadvantages of big boobs or ass in relationship. I'm sure you also have your opinion, so please, in the comment section, don't forget to leave it right there and we will interact with you. My name is Jeff Abuaje, and this has been Boys Kasa and content, people and places.
Voice cost saw.